Alright, hello guys, welcome to my tutorial on how to use the Autodesk Sketchbook app to draw. This is the app that I use all the time to create my cartoon drawings on my iPad that I have on my channel. It's a very user-friendly to use app, very easy to maneuver around, and the best thing about it is that it's free to download. Now let's get started on the features. So first of all, we have a blank white page. You can see on the left side, that's the drawing toolbar. You can toggle it up and down, and you can see it has a display of pencils, pens, erasers, and brushes. The first tool that I want to introduce is the pencil. So on the top right corner of the toolbar is a grayscale for you to adjust the thickness of the stroke by toggling up and down. Now you can see there's another grayscale that adjusts the stroke opacity. Toggle down for lower opacity and up for higher opacity. Now we'll use the eraser to get rid of the lines. Click here to open the full toolbar. I'll just click on some of them to show you what they look like. So basic tools are ones that are sufficient for artists of any level and are the ones that I've been using to draw my cartoons. Coming down, you have more advanced tools such as different style brush heads, marker pens, more brushes. You can even paint text styles and textures, which is really cool. Now let's check out the top toolbar. Now we have an undo button and a redo button. Now this one here is the crop tool. I'm going to draw a silly face and show you how to use the crop settings. So the first one on the left is the lasso, and that's my favorite crop tool shape to use. Just draw around anything you want to crop and you've got a crop shape. I'll show you how to alter the shapes in a minute. So moving to the right is the rectangular fixed crop shape. I don't know what tolerance means, I haven't had the time to experiment yet. This one helps move your crop shape in different directions. Left, right, up, down. And now the transformation button to change your crop image's shape or size. So first we select something that we want to crop. I always use the lasso. Let's do the left eye. First on the left is the scaling button. So I'm scaling the size of the left eye, as you can see. And the second one is positioning. See how I'm moving the eye from left to right? Now trying the mirror reflection butt function. You can do it either left, right, or up, down. Now I'm just trying to balance out the other eye. Now moving on to the paint function. With the ruler function, you can choose to have a circular or straight ruler to guide your drawing, which is cool when you want to draw a perfect circle or straight line. Now here's the reflector button. You can choose to reflect your drawing vertically, horizontally, diagonally, in multiple sections. You can do really cool kaleidoscope effects with this. You can also draw preset shapes like straight lines, ovals, squares. Now this one here, I call it the predictive stroke function. I don't find much use with it. Basically what it does is automatically smoothening out the lines that you draw. So unless you have really jittery hands, I don't see the point of this function. Click here if you want to add photos to your drawing. And here to add text. Just type in the text box here. Choose your font. Colors. You can even transform your text. For example, moving it around. Enlarging it. Changing its size. Moving it up and down, mirror reflected. The button on the furthest right is if you want to get rid of the three toolbars so you have a clearer view of your work. Now let's look at the color palette. You can choose different colors from the circular ring or on the H horizontal line, and the different tones and grayscale on the diamond area or the S and L lines. The tool on the top right is the color picker. Now I'll show you how to use layers like in Photoshop. I'll draw an eye to illustrate how to use layers in my drawing. So in the right column, you can see white squares. where each square is a layer. You can imagine it as drawing on several layers of transparent paper. So the layer I've chosen to draw is highlighted blue. Let's call this the outline layer. Now we'll go draw on a different layer on top of the outline layer. Let's call this the coloring layer. Let's change to the brush for coloring. I'm gonna choose a nice green hue for the iris, as my favorite color is green. Notice how the color doesn't go over the black outlines? That's the importance of using layers, so they don't overlap when you draw. Now you add another layer by clicking on the plus sign at the top of the column. Now this will be our shading layer. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Hit me up if you have any questions and I'll be able to answer them. Thanks for watching and please subscribe.